Hi, my name is Scott Haskins, and this video is an instructional video to help you know how to attach or mount these paintings to another surface. As a quick review of what we've done to prepare them, we have cleaned the reverse side of the paintings, the back of the canvas, and we've cleaned off all the paint or the other residual clumps of stuff. And so the paintings are now nice and smooth. By the way, these black dots that you see on the back are mold. The mold, by the way, is dead, and it has been killed through our process of consolidating and preparing the canvases, so you don't need to worry about it getting worse. These paintings, as you can see, are on a large table. This table heats up. It's called a vacuum hot table. And it allows us to warm up the paintings as we're treating them. And in fact, the adhesive that we put on is called Biva 371. And you can see it here in kind of a film form as it's dried. You can see that it's a nice thin. This is what is on the back of the painting. We put it on liquid, and then when it dries, you can see that it forms a sheet that is dry to the touch. And that's the layer that you're going to be activating when you put heat and pressure on the painting. On the front of the painting, you'll remember that there were little cracks and breaks where the painting had been kinked before, and little paint losses. And those are also consolidated so they will not lose any more paint. But one thing you need to know, and your part of the work on this is going to be activating this layer of adhesive. So the shininess that you see on the back of the paintings is this layer of adhesive that is activated by heat. Once again, here's that layer of adhesive that has formed a film, and that of course will be cut away, but that's what's on the back of the picture of the painting. By the way, the adhesive that we're putting on the backs of these paintings has been used in conservation for about 50 years. So it's a tried and true good product for working on paintings. The paintings with the new adhesive on the back and having already subjected them to heat already have the ripples or cracks greatly reduced. And now, and in fact, you can see here in the reflected light, they're not up anymore, and in fact they've almost disappeared, and we haven't even processed them for that cracking yet, so all of those cracks that you were worried about are going to be completely gone. The three things that you're going to need to mount this painting to another surface is the silicone release mylar that I have included with your shipment. You should find this in your packaging. Also, a regular hand iron, like you would use at home. And you can use either a roll of paper towels, or you can use a regular clean rag. You're going to turn the iron on to a medium heat, and that medium heat will allow you to wet your finger and touch it and have it just go psst, without it being super hot. And you'll want it to be more than warm, and you'll want it to not be super hot. Lay the release film against the painting, like so. And then you're going to take the iron, the hot iron, and you're going to warm the surface. But you're going to test the surface as you go with the back of your hand to make sure that you don't burn yourself. If you put your fingers on the painting and it's too hot, you have the painting too hot. So go slow with this, because you can burn the painting and scorch it. So you're going to warm the surface like this, and you're going to see that it is very warm without burning your fingers. Once the painting is very warm, you can take a piece of paper towel like this and rub it on the picture like this, or you can take the entire roll of paper towel like this and rub it. But I suggest that you rub it, and you rub it till it's semi-cool. It doesn't have to be cold, but it needs to be just barely warm when you're done rubbing it, okay? And that will ensure that the painting is well adhered to the surface below. So, to recap, you're going to use the silicone paper. You're going to use the iron to warm the surface to the point where it is very hot on the back of your fingers, but it doesn't burn them, and so that you can put it on there and say, ooh, that's hot. And but you don't want to get too much. You're watching the surface of the painting. Make sure you're not creating any problems. And then when it's warm, or when it's that hot, then you rub it in the area that you've worked on until it cools down and is barely warm. And at that point, the item should be well adhered. You can go back and reconnect maybe a little spot here, a little spot there, that you feel has not attached all the way, but the painting, after you rub it cool, should be well adhered. You can, if for some reason you should need to reposition the painting in another area, all you have to do is get the iron, warm it up, and lift this off of the surface. You can also use a hot air gun, or you can use even a hair dryer that gets this, you know, that'll get this really warm. The repositioning of the picture is if you get too much of the painting done, maybe something you really don't want to do. So make sure you get it right the first time. So that's it. It should go on nice and smooth and not give you any problems.
If you have any questions, be sure to call me. I'd be happy to walk through the process with you. And the only danger that you have, of course, is burning the painting with the iron if you let the surface get too hot. But you're monitoring the heat with the back of your hand. And if you're burning the back of your hand when you touch it, of course, you have the painting way too hot. So I think it'll go smooth for you. I don't think you have to worry. And I'm sure that it'll go fine. By the way, if you'd like a tour of the lab and see where we work on YouTube, there is another video that is a tour of our lab. Be sure to look through some of our other videos that we have also.